This would not be a privacy community without a scandal every once in a while. So let's cover the latest and greatest. The Brave browser, for those who don't know, is a browser that offers privacy and security out of the box. No configuration needed, with a familiar Chromium UI and fantastic speeds. If you want to learn more about Brave, I cover them in their own video breaking down the privacy and security aspects and what it means for you watching. Brave, though, had a recent scandal a few days ago. Someone on Twitter came out saying if you type a Binance link in the URL, you're not only suggested affiliate links for sites like Coinbase, Ledger, Binance, and Trezor, but for Binance specifically, if you hit enter on an incomplete URL, it would use the affiliate link as the URL, so you'd go to Binance.com from Brave's affiliate link, meaning Brave gets a commission if you were to buy or exchange any cryptocurrencies. This was all done without users being explicitly aware, and there was no setting or ability to opt out of this. The first problem here is the affiliate URL autocomplete for Binance, which is outright wrong. URLs are sacred, and if you hit enter in the omnibar, the browser should not be autofilling the rest of the URL with their own affiliate link. Any person on YouTube or other platforms who claims this isn't a problem or a big deal should be publicly shamed. They really should. On a moral level, this is totally wrong and could lead to a lot more scummy behavior utilizing these kinds of techniques. The second issue is the URL suggestions, which apply to affiliate links like Coinbase, Ledger, and Trezor. These were not autofilled if you hit enter, but they're still there in hopes of people clicking on them. So they're two separate problems. So, are these a big deal? It's hard, and it depends. From a privacy and security perspective, no. That is unaffected, thankfully. However, an important part of privacy, especially with so much misinformation, is trust. This should have been clearly disclosed before implementation, it should have been a setting, and defending this behavior at all by drawing comparisons to other people who did it is in itself a fallacy and doesn't defend their own behavior. I had a back and forth with the Brave CEO on Twitter, and he refused to just admit that this did, directly or indirectly, financially benefit Brave. This isn't directly a big deal. It doesn't impact the end user. People just feel used and a lack of trust, rightfully so, because this was never disclosed and done in like an underground sort of way. This is not the first scandal that Brave has undergone, for very similar reasons revolving around making a quick buck with no user awareness. The initial response being, it's not a big deal, then once people finally say, no, it is a big deal, they apologize and fix it. There is a pattern here. The weirdest thing is most things they do wouldn't be a big deal if they just said in advance, this is what we're doing. In terms of Brave's most recent response, they are fixing the so-called error, which is the Binance autofilled URL, and they're offering a setting for the suggestions. So it's more or less fixed, which is good, and that deserves a plus. As for the revenue problem, they are claiming they are working to receive no revenue from the autofilled Binance URL, but I'd like to see verification of that, if possible, because why would I trust Brave after this incident to just cut out the funding that they might have received? And that's really that. So what does this mean for you, myself, and tech lore as a whole? For viewers, privacy and security has not been compromised, but I hope you're more wary of Brave, as you should be. I wish Brave would stick to their values when making important decisions, so we wouldn't have to be so cautious with them. For viewers, would I recommend completely dropping the browser? It's your call, but I wouldn't personally tell you to jump ship just because of this. I've moved a lot of my friends over to Brave, and I don't think I'll tell them to stop just because of this one incident, and even the previous incidents, because none of them compromised user privacy and security. On a personal level, I think I am going to bite the bullet here and stop using Brave, which I've been using for the business for quite a while now. I'm probably going to move back to Firefox, despite so many issues with optimization within YouTube and other Google products, which I'm reliant on for this channel. I personally also had a discussion with the Brave CEO on Twitter, who I already didn't like, and I felt a complete loss of trust in the project from this conversation, and I'd rather just stop using them myself. As for tech lore, we are on Brave Rewards, and it's a healthy source of income for the channel, allowing you viewers to support us without giving any personal information, which is cool. I'm torn because on a personal, ethical level, I want to drop it completely because I don't want to be associated with this. But on the other hand, as a business, it's still a great option for supporting us with privacy and security in mind. it's a good source of income, and it doesn't negatively impact us or the supporters in any way. I'd really appreciate the community's feedback here. I've been going back and forth on this, and hearing your thoughts may help me decide. Do you care if Techlore has Brave Rewards as a support option, as long as we cover things transparently like we have, or would you prefer we shut it down altogether? Please leave your thoughts below so I can make a decision that'll keep people happy. No matter what, we're committed to covering topics with facts, and if we need to drop the Brave support link to do that, then so be it. On that note, thank you so much to patrons and everyone who has donated to us through both Patreon and Brave Rewards. It's absolutely incredible how much you're all willing to give back to our mission of spreading privacy and security to the masses, and I hope that what we do is reflecting that. Outside leaving your thoughts on Brave Rewards for Techlore, why don't you also leave your thoughts on this whole ordeal? Have you lost trust in Brave? Do you not care? What do you think? And lastly, don't forget to like and share this video to spread the word about the scandal, since I know not everyone has heard about it yet. Subscribe to keep up with any future updates, Go Incognito lessons, which are coming soon, surveillance reports, and other content to spread the word of privacy. Thank you all for watching. I'll see you next time.